How are you, Stefan?
Hi, I'm good. Good. It's good to be back to a movie theater after 2.5 years or so.
Yeah. Which movie are we watching today?
So we are watching So this is the sequel to a movie that is basically, imagine if you live in a world where you have to stay quiet all the time, plus if you have a family and there are many things going on, how do you keep all of that together while staying alive? So, nice premise.
Yeah. Do you remember the last movie that you saw in the theater before the pandemic
hit? The last movie that I saw was Hustle, actually. It was Hustle with J-Lo, Cardi B. That was a really nice movie. Stuff like that, and in a way, I kind of learned some more from them as well too.
J-Lo is rocking even at this age.
Yeah, she is indeed. Yes, go J-Lo. I'm a big fan.
Yeah, me too.
Did you watch the first part of A Quiet Place Part Two, and then what was your impression of it?
So I watched it like a couple of hours before arriving at the movie theater because I hadn't seen the first part, which came out in 2018. Mm-hmm. And yes, I really enjoyed the premise that, you know, the noise that you make kind of alerts, you know,
yes,
killing creatures, and so you have to stay quiet, you talk in sign language. Mm-hmm. So it's pretty good, you know. John Krasinski, I didn't think he could have handled story any better, so I thought more of him as an actor, you know, Jack Ryan, The Office, stuff like that.
Yeah.
But when I saw the treatment and the way he executed the movie, it's very well shot, very well performed. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I loved it. So I'm looking forward to the sequel.
Yeah. So now, what do you think will happen, or like, what you hope the sequel to, you know, to be the message, etc.?
I think so. This is going to be like a trilogy. So this, what second movie will do is like open up the universe a little bit. Mm-hmm. It will go from like the story of one family to more people being part of the narrative. Mm-hmm. And then by third movie, there will be some sort of like, you know, group, some sort of resistance that will form. And then we'll see what happens in the third film. But I think the universe is going to get bigger in this film.
Nice. Yes, I'm really excited. So after, you know, the movie, we will definitely give our reaction to it. That's for sure.
2 hours later.
Yeah, so we just watched A Quiet Place Part 2. And it was... overall, they did a great job. So it was a great transition into part three. And I love the fact that they made the scenery in terms of, you know, they had a deserted island, and then maybe that would be, you know, the best way for them to be secluded. So I like that premise and sense. But unfortunately, things went south and things didn't go as planned. But I love the parallel in how the kids show more bravery than the adults in the way they were thinking. So it's still, again, one of the key takeaway for me was to never doubt a young mind, because they can see, they can feel something that you may not, and sometimes you have to give them the opportunity to shine through, and they really highlighted that and to show that they were the adults. So yeah, they're saying that, you know, kids, you know, they are young because they don't know nothing, but this plot, this unique, you know, horror story shows you how this is not the case. So what did you think of part two?
I saw part one just before coming to movie theater, so the story was really fresh in my mind. Mm-hmm. I like that they expanded the universe a little bit, like, you know, they gave more nuance to the story and the creatures, and, you know, what are their weaknesses and how that could be exploited. So that was good. What I liked also was that, you know, the director creates a lot of tension in, you know, the scenes where there's sort of this feeling that the danger is like constantly around.
Yeah.
What I didn't like was that, you know, there aren't any you know, long chase sequences that kind of, you know, forever keeps you on the edge of, like, you know, they just ducked their death. Like, something like that, I think, is missing. I think that's something that they should have in, you know, third part, I guess. But, you know, it's like there should be like a chase sequence where they're constantly running for their life and things are, you know,
going more crazy. Chaotic.
So we saw in the opening sequence, and that was fun, but I wanted more of that. I wanted more of that, you know, edge of the seat kind of thing. So yeah, as I suspected, there will be Quiet Place 3, and so I guess in that one, you know, they should have sort of a bigger universe, in the sense that more and more people will form the story, and then we'll see how it goes from there. But yeah, I think, you know, they furthered the narrative, but yeah, they just only give you a little bit more, so it's not like a huge sort of you know, information from part one. So I mean, if you haven't seen part one, and if you go watch the part two, you'll be able to connect the dots, you know, for the most part. So yeah, but overall it was, I think, a good experience. You know, in theater it's worth to watch once at least.
Yes, at least. Awesome.